What is the street parking vault? What started as the Monday retest workout turned into the weekly vault workout. The vault is a one workout a week for 25 weeks series with new workouts each year.
Now the goal of the street parking vault is to help you guys build consistency by completing all 25 vault workouts within a 6-month period.
You can customize the movements in these workouts and choose any variation that fits your abilities.
Your scores and weights do not matter.
The goal is to maintain consistency from week to week.
Remember, you just can't
miss.
What's up, guys? Kim and I are getting ready to tackle Thor. I'm gonna be doing program B, so I have 15 barbell power snatches, and Kim is gonna be doing program A, so she has 20 dumbbell snatches. Make sure to stick around after the workout for my tips, and if you need to see the demo video or customizations and all that jazz, head over to my.streetparking.com or the Street Parking app. So many.
And they're off with Thor.
This workout's gonna make you Thor.
Gonna get super Thor.
Your forearms might be a little Thor. Your upper body, let's say. Your upper body for sure.
I love it.
All right, so we got a 100 meter farmer carry.
Okay.
Okay, every 3 minutes, every we're gonna be minutes. Doing a 100 meter farmer carry, followed by, depending on what you're doing. So Alex is using the barbell. She's gonna be doing 15 hang power snatch and then max reps of push-up taps.
Nice.
That's a push-up and one tap on one side, one tap on the other side each time.
Yes.
You're gonna keep doing that in what you might call a, what did you call it? A cyclone? Vortex.
A vortex, a fitness vortex.
Until you get to 100 reps
yes.
of the push-up taps.
Yes, that's a lot. Of push-up taps.
It's a lot of push-up taps. I know right before we started, Kim seems more nervous about this than she normally is.
Really? Uh-oh, danger. Kim's nervous?
Yeah, she like wrote it down. She was saying she doesn't know if she's going to be able to hold the 15. So the goal time for this is 15 to 21 minutes. So that's 5 to 7 rounds because
okay.
they're 3-round cycles.
That makes sense.
So yeah, you're looking at like 15 push-up taps each time, which I think she's going to be fine. But as you know, push-ups are one of those movements.
Yes, once it's gone.
You can't just will your way through it.
Yes. Once it's gone, it's gone. Once you're done, once your arms say, I'm done, they mean it.
Yeah, they're not playing around.
They're not.
So Alex is doing the 15 hang power snatches with the barbell. Kim did 20. If you're doing the dumbbell version, it's 20 alternating hang dumbbell snatches. So they've got about a minute 15 to do these push-up taps. I mean, Alex is moving at a pace.
And then if you're doing the program C sandbag version, you can do mm-hmm. a 15 hang to overhead.
With the sandbag, and it's a suitcase carry.
I like a suitcase carry.
You know, every time I hear about a suitcase carry, I picture this one time when Salvi, we gave him a really heavy bag.
He was so big.
And Salvi's not the tallest person.
No.
And so any of you that are not tall know that the sandbags sometimes, when you try to do a suitcase carry, are very close to the ground.
Very close
and
to the ground.
And it was like pulling him over, almost dragging on the ground, and I will never forget it. That was like my intro to us doing suitcase carry.
So good.
In the
so
workouts.
Good.
Now, something smart that you might want to do that we encouraged Kim to do is because there's a lot of counting in this workout.
Yes.
And you got to get to 100 reps. So maybe right before you leave on the farmer carry each time, just write where you were at.
Really should.
Write it down because you're going to come in and you're going to be like, was I at 27 or 37?
You're going to think you know in your mean? Head. You're going to be like, I'm going to make a mental note. No, you're not. You're not
no,
going to make a
mental note.
You're
not going to remember. Especially when you got to come in and count the snatches and everything.
100%.
She didn't write it down, though. She
nope.
did not take
danger,
our advice.
Danger. Not written down. Danger. We have entered the danger zone. She's going to be Thory.
She's going to be very Thor-y. She did that.
All right, let's talk about Thor. This is the one I feel like everybody knows who Thor is.
People know about Thor. I think this is great. So I don't know, because this year's vault workouts were created mostly by Alex and Jeb. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if that dumbbell hang snatch is like, is that the hammer?
Oh, yeah.
Is that the hammer in the air?
That's definitely Mjolnir right there. Yeah,
right?
I feel like the hammer.
That would make sense. And just you're going to be super jacked in your upper body, which yes. people think of, you know. Chris Hemsworth yeah. and Thor and the whole thing. And so it's
100%.
It's just great. It's going to be fun. What other tidbits? Because I know you always prepare stuff about the gods.
Yeah, no, he's the hammer wielding god. He's associated with strength and the protection of mankind. He's the son of Odin. And you guys know him as Chris Hemsworth. So there's that.
And or Chris Hemsworth.
I have to say, when I did listen to the book that I've gotten most of my information about on this one is...
Hope it's accurate.
Accurate as it can be, right?
Who knows?
It's mythology. You can just make it up
it's
and say
it was real. It's all mythology these days.
All mythology nowadays. but I noticed in listening to it, I actually didn't like Thor anymore.
Oh.
The book made him seem just like very... let's say not intelligent and like pretty cocky.
I mean, I think that kit fits the character from the movies too.
But he was funny. He was like endearing and had like things that made you still like him. But in the book, I was like, oh, this guy, here he goes again, doing something crazy, just okay. wanting his hammer back. He never thinks of anything but his stinking hammer.
Is that okay?
What?
Moving right along. No, this one, I think this one's going to sneak up on you. I'm interested to see this time before they leave, we should ask them where they're at to see if they're holding that pace.
Or if they even know.
Right? Hopefully they know. There is an extra challenge option for this.
What's the extra challenge?
Going up to 120 push-up
no,
tap taps.
No, thank you.
Now, you might think that's only 20 extra.
That's a lot
But
extra
it's a lot of taps.
100.
It's a lot of extra taps.
40
and
extra taps.
That's right. And even just adding two or three more per round
yeah.
seems impossible with a movement like this.
That's true.
So 20 can end up taking you two more full cycles.
100%.
For sure.
What is the shift version of this workout?
I'll tell you the shift version while they're on their farmer carry. Let's find out where they're at.
Okay.
40. Okay, so Alex is holding 20. Where are you at, Kim?
I think she said same. Yeah. Wow. They're both
okay,
at 40.
Okay, so they're doing great. That 40 would get them into the 5 rounds. So if they can hold that, they will be able to finish in 5 rounds, which is the bottom of the goal time, or the faster end of the goal
yes.
time. So we'll see if they. I feel like this is the round that's going to decide if they're going to be able to continue holding 20.
I don't want to say complete faith. I have partial faith that they'll be able to hold 20.
Now, I want you guys to notice that Kim started out with knee push-ups, and that's smart for her because she knows. She knew. She was like, if I try to do toe push-ups, maybe one round that's going to go great, and then it's not going to go great. So we don't call them girl push-ups.
No.
Here, it's just it's a customized push-up for your ability level, and with a workout like this where it could turn into a vortex very quickly.
100%.
Like, know what you need to do and just do it from the get-go.
Yeah.
And don't be afraid to go to that push-up somewhere. I feel like this song is really inappropriate right now, but it's great.
It might just be. Didn't you pick this song?
This is from my playlist, yes.
This is your pick? Let's all listen to the words on this song and feel the inappropriateness of Miranda's playlist.
You'll notice that Alex is breaking up the snatches, I think into sets of five.
The reason I said that I don't have complete faith, but a solid bit of partial faith in their keeping with this one in the workout is because, like you said, with the push-ups, like once they're gone, mm-hmm. right? I think mm-hmm. they have the mental grind to get through it, but this is one of those ones with those push-ups and those taps. Once they start to fail, I feel like we'll see it in the last round. They're going to have to really tap in to keep this going.
Okay, so shift. We didn't talk about shift yet. Shift is 8 rounds. Which is a total of 12 minutes, because I think each round is 90 seconds. That's a lot of math. But anyways, you're doing 8 rounds, 30 seconds of farmer carry. And if you need to, you can do like a low step up farmer carry or even walk in place for 30 seconds.
Okay.
If if your kid is in there or something, you don't want to leave him. 30 seconds of alternating dumbbell hang snatch and then 30 seconds. So basically the movements are the same, but we're ending your thing at 30 seconds each time.
Love it.
So 30 seconds, 30 seconds, 30 seconds, 8 rounds through.
I like that.
And there's no specific number you have to hit for shift. You're just going to do as many push-up tap taps in that 30-second window each time. So less chance of a vortex.
I like that all the time. as little time as I can spend in the vortex as possible, please.
These guys are getting about a minute of... Oh, they're looking a little... The push-ups are looking a little slower.
You're starting to hear little noises.
The lockout is questionable now.
The lockout is not as defined as before.
Kim's arms are turning red.
Yes.
There's a blood flow happening. Do you guys hold 20? 60? Okay.
That arm pump, though, after this one, they're going to be...
57. Ooh, Alex fell off a little bit.
They're going to be jacked at the end of this one. We're going to have to get Aki to take a bunch of, like, really cool bro-y pictures of how jacked and awesome their arms are going
to look. Yeah, this is a great
one
to do right before, you know, a pool party,
right on.
Clubbing. Whatever it might be. This is a great one for that.
But not like the day or two before, because then you'll be overly Thor.
There's going to be a lot of Thorness in the chest. A
lot of
and
Thorness.
The shoulders.
A lot of Thorness. And
how
you
many
don't
times
be...
can we use the same joke?
Look, when it's a good one, you stick with it.
Now, again, Alex has been breaking up the power snatches, which I think is really smart. The lockout's going to start getting less comfortable, regardless of what version you're doing. Really wanting to focus on like a big hip drive in that so that you're not having to really press those out. Again, with the dumbbells, the sandbag, or the barbell, use your lower body on those snatches as much as you possibly can.
Yeah. What do you think you will want to use equipment-wise for this workout?
You know, I like a barbell power snatch, but I haven't done them in a really long time.
Yeah.
And they're one movement that gives my shoulder issues because I have some old shoulder stuff. So I'll probably try the barbell in the warm-up and see how that goes. If not, I'll go with the dumbbells. The dumbbell version of this one's nice because you could do it. You could take this to like a park really easily
yes.
or something like that.
You'd get a tan.
Yeah, because you would just need a pair of dumbbells and you could be outside and doing the whole thing outside. Which sounds nice for this time of year.
100% see myself doing this with the dumbbell.
A sandbag hang to overhead is hard.
Yeah.
If it's not my favorite challenge, that's a really hard movement, but it's fun and you feel really badass kind of doing that.
No, it's very cool because you get to like drop it. The issue with that one for me personally is it lights my low back up, so I have to be really mindful of
as
it comes down to the hang. Mm-hmm. Yeah, be very mindful of your form on that one so you don't end up being Thor-y. I can't.
Kim's looking really strong. She's taking short breaks. What you don't want to do on push-ups is ever get to where, like, I don't know if I'm going to complete the next rep.
Right.
So you want to stop a couple reps shy of that, unless it's your last round and you're just trying to finish. If you ever get to, like, I might not be able to lock out this push-up.
Stop a second.
You're going to be in trouble, especially if you're not close to being done.
Exactly, because then A, you've just wasted that however much of the rep you did get before you failed it, and B, you just pushed your arms to a whole nother level and they're mad at you now. They're so mad at you now.
I want to challenge you guys too. Push-ups are one of those movements that we can get pretty sloppy and we can
push-ups.
End up doing like this big like snake off the ground thing. Try not to do that. Try to make these solid, legit push-ups. Go all the way down at the bottom, completely lock out at the top, but keep your belly tight. Flex your legs, squeeze your butt if you're doing them on your toes, and try to keep a good position.
There they are again, top of the minute, going for
another
100 meters.
So if Kim's been able to hold 20, this should be her last round. I think Alex is going to have to do another one at this point, but if she's been able to hold 20, this should be what finishes it for her.
That's dope. Alex, I think, is trying to kind of speed up her farmer carry so she can maybe make up those reps right now. She was kind of almost, I wouldn't say jogging, but moving quickly for a height-challenged individual.
legs. I'm going to throw it out there, too. If you guys are looking to exercise your fitness freedom and you're trying to do the summer grind.
Yeah.
I mean, a little sled push instead of the farmer carry might be kind of fun.
Oh, okay.
A little sled push. I wouldn't recommend a pole because it does take a minute to get into the pole sled.
Okay,
which
I got
you. Can eat into that three-minute window.
Yeah.
Which the three-minute window is important for this one, and you don't want to eat into the time at all. But a little sled push would be,
that could be
super
really
fun for this one.
For sure.
Oh, Kim's, she's like, I'm over this. I'm going to finish this. I'm gonna get out of this thing. I'm gonna get out of the vortex.
Out of the vortex.
She's got that hammer. She's throwing it around.
Look at Thor going back there. Wow, wow, wow. Yeah, no, she's definitely speeding through. She wants to knock this out ASAP.
Well, you guys all know how that is. You're like, oh, okay, I can finish. And then you're like, but I just want to make sure I finish.
Right, 100%. There's nothing worse than having like one or two reps left in something like this.
No, and then you got to do the whole lead up to get the last few reps. So come they've on, got guys, about a got minute this. 20.
Oh, yeah, going for it for sure. Really trying to finish in this one, Kim is. Oh, taking a little break,
Alex,
but
you
the
can
arms
see she's down to like sets of like two or three. That'll definitely be me. Push-ups are so hard. Why are push-ups so hard?
I don't know.
It's a small muscle group moving your entire body. That's why, Nicole.
I think it's because it's a small muscle group moving your entire body.
Nice.
Gotcha. I think that's what it is.
Let me give you the answer here.
Did you see the panic on my face?
I mean, it was more of a rhetorical question, but then I could see you were trying to answer it.
I'm like, oh no. I was not prepared.
I think Kim just said shit.
Oh no. Maybe not getting out of it on this one.
Oh, she's got 30 seconds left. I said before to Kim, before they started, how did you get sucked into this one? She's like, I don't know.
You never can tell around here. I remember one day I thought I was coming over to commentate. Next thing you know, I was doing the workout, and I was like, what?
Oh, yeah, you never know.
Happened?
All right, so Alex is going to have to go one more time. How many got left?
Aw, Alex got a boo-boo.
87.
She got 13 left.
13 left.
Oh, Kim Kim's made it with done. 2 seconds to spare.
Dang.
She got through the vortex.
Made it. So it's down to Alex with 13 left.
Let's talk about this. Kim was worried that she wasn't going to make the goal time.
Yes.
She was worried that she wasn't going to be able to hold 15. Mm-hmm. She ended up holding 20.
Yeah.
In 6 months.
Yep.
Maybe try starting from the toes. See what happens. Because she hit that bottom end of the goal range. Yeah. So build some little confidence and be like, you know what? Maybe for the first 50, I'll go for my toes in six months or something like that. Now that she knows that she can do it from the knees.
I think that's a solid plan. We should let her know. Next time around, be like, you know what, Kim?
Next time around, toes. I know. At least for the first half.
50-50.
Yeah.
I just want to be able to push
the yeah.
All right, Alex, she's got 13 push-up tap-taps left. Wow. Now, that sounds super doable, but at sets of 2 and 3, she's not going to want to, like, dilly-dally.
Yeah, and at this point, she's really going to want to make sure she gets all those 13 or else the buy-in again.
She's got to do the whole thing again.
Yes.
And it's not a small buy-in.
No,
I mean, it's like 15 of those hang snatches. That's a lot.
Dang, dang, dang. I don't know if you guys could hear, but Kim said she wanted to keep the intensity high, which is one of the reasons why she went from her knees this time around. But yeah, I think she'll hit some toes on the next one for sure.
This isn't one of those ones, too, where you're like, oh, I'm crushing it after the first round. Let me increase the whatever. Like, just do the whole thing from your knees if you start out that way and see how it goes.
Yeah, yeah.
All right. She's got about a minute 20. I think that was 2 reps.
And here's the third and the fourth.
Now, this is smart. She's keeping her hands like there. Mm-hmm. She's got time to do it.
Nice, Alex.
She's keeping her breaks short. Even if you go to singles for these last like 10, 15 reps, as long as you don't break for too long, you can make it happen.
I think that was 8. Nine.
Come on, Alex.
Nice, Alex.
That body weight strength program she's been doing, you know what I mean?
Nailing it.
Come on, Alex, two more.
Oh, yeah, she's got this.
Oh, I think she's done.
That was it? Oh. Yep, she definitely has this.
We were so engaged in that, we couldn't even speak. I've been so interested in a set of push-up tap-taps in my life.
Push-up tap-taps.
All right.
Nailed them.
Let's hear from Alex, her coach's tips, and look at how awesome her shoulders and her biceps look.
Yeah, yeah. Just make sure, like, during this entire tip portion, you just really focus in on the jackedness of Alex's arms. Oh, hi, Salvi. How are you?
Oh, hi.
How are you today?
Okay, so I cannot underestimate this enough. You have time for maybe one break on the former carry. So go with a weight that you are confident, like you could do the 100 meters unbroken. I broke from the start because I knew that that, especially paired with a barbell snatch, where both of my hands were gonna be under tension for a long time, that was gonna be a small saving grace in a long line of grip-heavy work. I even was kind of like half-jogging towards the end. My grip was failing on the back half, but I mostly just needed to get in here sooner and buy myself more time to work with the barbell and then with the push-ups. Go with a weight on the snatches, especially if you're doing barbell, that you have like no question you could do all 15 unbroken. 55 pounds is a very, very light weight for me. Similar to the former carry, I broke those up into 6.54 from the start, knowing that my grip was gonna fatigue. And just to give my heart rate a chance to settle down, since a hang power snatch is one that will get you breathing heavy and your heart pumping really fast. But yeah, guys, if you're going with a weight that's like questionable or like you wouldn't be able to do 15 unbroken, I don't know that you're gonna last in this workout. For the push-ups, break early, break often. Try to keep your breaks short. At most, in the beginning, I was sitting back on my heels just to give my hands a break. Towards the end, I was breaking into sets of two and then singles, keeping my hands planted and just shifting my weight back because I had to. Like, my triceps were just shot. And I would say I'm a strong push-upper, so do not underestimate that. If you are like mediocre at push-ups, I think maybe you could start on your toes, but then be willing to customize in the middle of the workout if you're not getting between 15 and 20 reps in each round. That can be going to your knees, that can be elevated on a box or a bench, but just make sure that you're able to keep moving. When I realized that I was gonna have to do another round past like what I thought, because I thought I was gonna be able to hold 20s and just do five rounds, and when I knew I was gonna have to do a sixth round, I got really in my head. So just anticipate your plan failing and have ways to manage that, cope with it in your head, or customizations to help you stay moving. So an appropriate workout for Thor, I must say. He definitely dropped the hammer on us. I hope you guys enjoy it.
Week 24 of the Vault is Thor. Your Program B workout is every 3 minutes, you're going to perform a 100 meter former carry, followed by 15 barbell hang power snatches. And then with any time remaining in the 3 minute window, you're going to accumulate as many push-up plus taps as you can. You're going to continue with that pattern, starting a new round every 3 minutes, until you complete 100 push-up plus taps. Your score is the total time it takes you to get to that 100th rep, and your goal is to finish it in 15 to 21 minutes. So in order to hit that 15 to 21 minute goal for this one, guys, you're gonna need to complete at least 14 to 20 push-up plus taps each round. So a good bet is to give yourself at least a minute to work towards those reps. That's going to mean customizing, if you need to, the former carry and the snatches so that you get those things done in 2 minutes or less. It'll also mean, even if you have a minute, that you're choosing a push-up variation that allows for you to hit those numbers. So take all of that into consideration before you tackle this one and have fun. If you'd like to see more detailed demos of the movements in today's workout, or if you need to see customization options to make it work for you, head over to my.streetparking.com. Week 24 of the vault is Thor. Your shift workout today is 8 rounds. Each round is 30 seconds of a farmer carry, followed by 30 seconds of alternating hang power snatches, and then 30 seconds of push-up plus taps. Your score for this one is the total number of reps of hang power snatch and push-up plus taps combined. And your goal is to complete 95 to 145 reps. In order to hit the goal for this one, guys, we want you to aim for at least 8 to 12 of the hang power snatch and 4 to 6 of the push-up plus taps each round. So make sure that you are keeping that in mind when you're choosing your weight for the hang power snatch and the variation of the push-up for the push-up plus taps. We'd love to see you challenge yourself on the carry. If you only have one heavy weight, you could just hold it in one hand and alternate hands each round. When it comes to the hang power snatch, just know that you are counting every rep as one. So the right side would be one, left side would be two, right side would be three, so on and so forth. If you'd like to see more detailed demos of the movements in today's workout, or if you need to see customization options to make it work for you, head over to my.streetparking.com.